In 1984, a cult preaching free love and meditation carried out a bioterrorism attack. The history of the Rajneesh movement is as fascinating as it is terrifying. Here's the story behind the largest bioterrorist attack in US history. Bhagwan Sri Rajneesh, also known as Osho, was born in Chandra Mohan Jain in Kuchwada, India, on December 11, 1931. After taking time off from school for soul-searching and meditation, Osho returned, claiming to have found enlightenment.
I was asleep, now I am awake. You are asleep, and you can be awake also.
While teaching philosophy at the University of Jabalpur, Osho traveled around India spreading his teachings about spirituality and free love. By the mid-1960s, he was leading meditation camps, and soon he'd resigned from teaching to focus on being a guru full-time. It was around this time that he got the nickname, the Sex Guru. Osho would later become known as the Rolls-Royce Guru as well, due to the 74 Rolls-Royces he collected. Osho preached dynamic meditation to all who came to his six-acre ashram, and many ended up staying for extended periods of time. Then the ashram became too crowded, and the local government made it difficult to find a new place to relocate to, which is part of what led Osho and his followers to the United States. Founded by Osho, the Rajneesh movement, also known as Sannyasin, was a cult that combined aspects of Eastern and Western spirituality into a belief system that focused on indulgence. Their ideology was based around an idea of self-fulfillment without rules or a narrow view of morality. At one point, his followers were also known as the Orange People, though later they also started dressing in red. Although Osho preached enlightenment and living in harmony with their surroundings, he enforced a mentality that led to an isolated community that kept tight control over its members. The cult would also extract donations from its members, sometimes telling them to call their parents to ask for upwards of $20,000. While the Rajneeshi were in India, Osho often found himself at odds with Indian officials, who responded in kind by blocking expansion plans for his ashram, denying visas to Westerners, and opening criminal investigations. As a result, in 1981, he decided to move his cult to the United States. After purchasing land in southern Wasco County and Jefferson County, the Rajneeshis started creating a planned community. Initially called Rancho Rajneesh, Rajneeshpuram claims to have hosted 15,000 followers at its height, although other sources place the number closer to 2,000.
I'm here in one of the largest ranches in the Northwest, 100 square miles of Oregon. Used to be known as the Big Muddy Ranch. Today, it's Rajneeshpuram.
The cult purchased over 60,000 acres and created their own town, which included an airstrip, restaurants, and a fire department. By 1982, they applied to become the city of Rajneeshpuram, and Wasco County approved their incorporation. Ma Anand Sheela was born in 1950 in Baroda, India. Sheela was introduced to Osho when she was 16 years old and was instantly devoted to him. Although she soon left India to go attend university in the United States, where she studied architecture, in 1972 Sheela returned to India and began working closely with Osho. Sheela became Osho's personal secretary and was soon working on marketing the guru as a global brand. She figured out their move to the United States and was instrumental in creating the mini-city of Rajneeshpuram. Sheela was the mastermind behind several other campaigns as well. After moving the cult to Oregon, Sheela reportedly came up with the plan to artificially increase voters claiming to live in Rajneeshpuram to win political battles. And when that plan failed, she was part of the group that concocted the bioterror attack. Sheela always felt that Osho had a dream, and she was the only one who could put it into practice. That and when Osho was in isolation, Sheela was his only contact with the outside world. Despite preaching love and harmony, the Rajneeshis were responsible for many cases of abuse. The cult claimed to maintain free love as a tenet, but there were reports of sessions at Osho's ashram in India in which participants were beaten and encouraged to act out their most violent fantasies. all of this to cleanse themselves of aggression. And although free love was supposedly encouraged, any children that might result out of such love were not. If a woman got pregnant at the Pune ashram in India or Rajneeshpuram in Oregon, she was given a choice. She could agree to have an abortion or leave the property. There were no children born in Oregon to Rajneesh cult members during the height of its influence. Sterilization was also encouraged for women and was considered mandatory for Osho's top woman officials. Before long, the Rajneeshis had encroached upon the neighboring town of Antelope, and by February 1983, they had won control of the Antelope City Council. Soon after, they changed the name of the town to Rajneesh and raised property taxes to drive the remaining residents out. In the summer of 1984, the cult realized that the only way to get the building permits that they wanted was to take over Wasco County. They would have to replace at least two out of the three sitting commissioners, which would prove difficult considering that the Rajneeshis accounted for less than 10% of the county's population. So they came up with a two-step plan. They would increase the population of their cities, and they would incapacitate and suppress turnout among those who might vote against them. Initially, the cult encouraged non-resident sannyasins and sympathizers to move to the city and register to vote in Wasco County. When they realized that their population numbers were still too low, the Rajneeshis came up with this share-a-home program, where they targeted homeless people and bused them into Rajneeshpuram. In the summer of 1984, homeless people were bused into Rajneeshpuram by the hundreds as part of the share-a-home program. It's estimated that upwards of 3,000 homeless people were brought to Rajneeshpuram. The Rajneesh public relations person claimed that the purpose of the program was to share with some people who have been less fortunate than we have. However, there was an incredibly deliberate motive behind the Rajneeshis' actions. Everyone who was brought into Rajneeshpuram was expected to register to vote and then vote for the cult's favored candidate. However, the cult hadn't considered the fact that many of the homeless people that they brought to Rajneeshpuram also suffered from untreated mental illnesses. Fights often broke out, and to regain control, they injected the tranquilizer Haldol into beer kegs and served the tainted alcohol to the homeless. The cult also discovered through bugged public payphones that Felton Walker, one of the homeless people brought to the commune, was planning to kidnap Osho. He was injected with sodium pentothal and interrogated for hours. Several days later, he was kicked off the ranch. Eventually, the cult abandoned their plan and forced all the homeless people back off Rajneeshpuram. In the end, the newly registered voters were required to attend a hearing due to suspicions of voter fraud, and many of the new registrations were rejected. The second part of the sannyasins' plan involved poisoning people with Salmonella enterica, a bacterium that causes salmonellosis in people. First, two county commissioners who visited the commune were given water laced with salmonella. Both became incredibly ill, and one spent 4 days in the hospital. However, the Rajneeshis were still unable to get the building permits they wanted, so they decided to run a trial poisoning on a larger scale. The Rajneeshis went to 10 restaurants around September and October in 1984, and when nobody was looking, poured salmonella-tainted liquid on items in the salad bar. Over 750 people were affected, making it the largest bioterrorist attack in U.S. history. Fortunately, no one died as a result of the attack, but before long, emergency rooms were seeing waves of infected people. Although no one was certain, many residents of Wasco County believed that the Rajneeshis were responsible for the poisoning. But initially, even the CDC felt that the food handlers were the most likely source for the introduction of the bacteria into the salad bars. It took a year for the CDC to finally attribute the attack to the Rajneeshis. Residents of Wasco County maintained their suspicions, but without any hard evidence, there was little to incriminate Osho's followers. However, this didn't stop people from speaking out. Oregon Congressman Jim Weaver gave a speech to the U.S. House of Representatives on February 28, 1985, where he indirectly accused the Rajneeshis of causing the salmonella outbreaks. Weaver even went on to accuse the cult of having a laboratory in Rajneeshpuram, but his speech was written off as rambling and incoherent, which was delivered to a nearly empty chamber. In the original plan, the Rajneeshis were going to use Salmonella typhi, which causes typhoid fever, which would have certainly resulted in many deaths. The salad bar attacks were meant to be a trial run for a larger poisoning right before the election, likely through the town's water supply. At one point, the leaders even considered flying a plane filled with bombs into the county courthouse. Around the time that all of this was going on in the fall of 1984, Osho was coming out of a self-imposed vow of silence that had lasted roughly 3.5 years. However, until the following summer, speaking in public meant speaking to a small group of disciples he called the Chosen Ones. In the summer of 1985, Osho set out to fix the Rajneeshis' public image. In addition to holding interviews and a press conference, the Rajneeshis sued Oregon state officials, accusing them of trying to push them out of Oregon. But after Sheila and several other high-ranking sannyasins abruptly left the cult on September 14, 1985, Osho quickly changed his tune. 2 days later, Osho held a press conference and accused Sheila and other Rajneeshi officials of creating a Salmonella outbreak and conspiring to kill numerous people. At one point, Osho also claimed that Sheila was trying to kill him as well. Osho invited officials to come to the ranch to investigate his accusations, and on October 2nd, a state federal task force raided the commune. Upon entering the commune, the FBI discovered a fully fledged bioterrorism lab. In addition to the laboratory, officials found an arsenal of guns, evidence of a wiretapping operation, and a top-secret research project by the Rajneesh Medical Corporation to develop a live AIDS virus.
We had no idea that we were going to run into the largest poisoning case in the history of the United States.
The lab contained books including Deadly Substances, Handbook for Poisoning, The Perfect Crime, and How to Commit It, and Let Me Die Before I Wake. It also had numerous articles on assassinations, explosives, and terrorism. The Rajneeshis' connection to the Salmonella outbreak was also confirmed when a state laboratory director noticed a vial containing a strain of the bacteria that matched the outbreak strain. Despite having invited the authorities in, Osho was soon complaining that investigators were simply out to destroy him. However, agents weren't deterred, and by the end of October had issued an indictment against Osho. Osho tried to flee by plane, but he was arrested in North Carolina after landing to refuel. However, the only thing that Osho was charged with was violating immigration law. Meanwhile, Sheila was already in West Germany, where she'd fled in September with Ma Anand Pooja. Fortunately, she and Pooja were soon captured and extradited to the United States. Pooja and Sheila were charged with attempted murder, electronic eavesdropping, immigration fraud, and engineering a Salmonella outbreak that sickened more than 750 people. They have both pleaded no contest. After receiving multiple sentences ranging from 4.5 to 20 years, they both ended up being released after 29 months. Sheila was also fined $469,000. Several other Rajneeshi officials and members were also indicted and sentenced. After her release, Sheila was deported to Switzerland. Osho ended up pleading guilty to the immigration charges in 1985, and, after being given a suspended sentence and a $400,000 fine, he was ordered to leave the United States. He returned to India and continued to claim until his death in 1990 that Sheila was behind it all. After Osho left the country, Rajneeshpuram began to crumble as well. A U.S. District Court judge in Portland ruled that the incorporation of Rajneesh, Oregon violated the separation of church and state, and it was ordered to disband by the end of 1985. Even though this was later overturned, by this point many followers had left, and some had even sold Osho's Rolls Royces to raise money to start their lives over. Some members left the cult to rejoin their families or continued to travel as they searched for purpose. Some found themselves lost or penniless. They had gone through an identity crisis and didn't know what to do after following Osho so closely. They had committed to the cult so completely, it had become their life's purpose. Others maintained their affiliation with the Rajneeshi and simply moved to another commune elsewhere in the world. Osho's followers in India renamed his commune the Osho International Meditation Resort. And today there are hundreds of Osho meditation centers in 80 countries. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more grunge videos about U.S. history are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.